Okay, everyone that wants regular coffee, it is finally ready. Don't everybody rush at once, but finally the caffeine is there for you.
My mic went, ooh, yeah, I'm working. Test. There we go. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. That wasn't me. Hi, Quinn. Thank you all for joining us yet again another time of the season. The winter holidays begin to come. We get this cold outside, and I start thinking it's about time for Polar Express and Mr. Kirkpatrick and Miss Bell deliver. Thank you for joining us this evening. Tonight we are celebrating our music and celebrating all things that are winter on the traditional and unceded territory of the Catesy and Kwantlen First Nation. We are very lucky to live, work, and play in a community that gives us such beauty, but also such passion, and also such compassion. We are truly, truly lucky to live here. This evening we're also joined by a few members of our community council, which I've noticed, and then as well a number of members of our school board, which is very nice for them to see and show and understand the strength that we do in our community. My name is Ian Liversidge. I'm very, very proud to be the principal of this school that offers complete music experience, as well as so many other things that we do here. Academics, the production of Grease is going this week, if you happen to be able to do that, and then as well, tomorrow, of course, there'll be basketball in here, et cetera, et cetera. Perfect. Today we start the performances. Mr. Kirkpatrick will take over with the introductions. The beautiful thing about this show at this time of year is that it begins to show the progression. This year in the BC Honor Choir, BC Honor Band, that's about a 70-member band made up of senior-age musicians from the province of BC, school-age musicians. There are 3 Garibaldi students that are participating in that program. That's an unbelievable ratio. And it speaks well to the quality and progression that we have and we have established here. And that's largely due to Ms. Bell and Mr. Kirkpatrick. So without further ado, Mr. Kirkpatrick with the first of our bands. Thank you, sir.
Hi, Quinn. You guys need the very first note of Hot Cross Buns. Okay. The very first note, ready? Sit up straight, feet flat on the floor. Could you hear that?
No.
No. 1, 2, 3. Thank you.
I just hit the mute button. I know how this works. This is our elementary band. As you can tell, there's actually some older students in there, so I don't know how, but I convinced like 15 student aides to help me in this class, which is awesome, which means that they can help the kids next to each other and do a lot more of the work, which means we can do a lot more music playing a lot faster, which makes my job so much easier. So we've got three tunes for you tonight. The first tune is Hot Crust Buns, but I had the thought that I should have changed the words to Krispy Kreme Donuts, because that's what we're selling tonight, right? I can't remember the prices, so someone will correct me. It looks like a dollar, two for a? $2 for a donut. And for six? A dozen for? A dozen for 15. They'll tell you again later. But instead of saying Hot Crust Buns, the tune that we all know, Krispy Kreme Donuts is what I came up with. So try that, okay? Here we go. Short and sweet, the way we like it. Our last two tunes, I won't do too much talking between. The first one is going to be Good King Wenceslas. What's the word when you've got soloists that you're going to talk about? We're going to feature four different groups today. We're going to have the flutes, we're going to have the clarinets, we're going to have the saxophones, and then the mighty brass section. I'm a brass player, I'm a little biased. And then after that, we're going to do a rendition of Jolly Old St. Nicholas to finish off the show for our portion. So here we go. We have Good King Wenceslas and Jolly Old. I come back again? Thank you, Richard. So we're just going to do a quick set change between stage A and B. Some of the kids need to move over to junior jazz, and the grade 8s are just going to quickly get ready with minimal amounts of talking, I might add. That's what every parent says too, right? Okay, so we'll just give us like 1 minute to get this started, and I'll tell you all about the Junior Jazz Band. All right, so we're ready to go. The Junior Jazz Band is going to play a tune for you called Rumblebee. This is arranged by a guy named Richard Lopez. He does a lot of like the real basic beginner jazz band stuff. It's a really cool little rock tune. The power behind these kids is absolutely astounding in this tune. I'm going to let the chart do the rest of the talking. Here is Rumblebee. So on this next tune, I am sure I owe some parents some apologies, because I know I owe Ms. Bell an apology for this one. I gave them this tune, and it's the only thing they'd play all the time. It's unbelievable how this gets stuck in their ears. It's crazy. Even the ones that maybe practice a little bit less than I'd like them to, they know who they are. Even they started practicing. It was great. So, Ms. Bell, I'm sorry. I have for you what's the other thing I keep, it's not Jazzy Merry Christmas, is what I keep calling it for some reason. This is Jingle Bell Rock. These kids are killing it.
check.
But I'm not going to conduct it. So this is, stand up, come on, don't be shy. This is Eric. Eric is one of our student aides in this class. We have Kevin in here and Ashton as well. And I'm glad he has fans already. Eric's going to conduct the first song for us. This is Eric conducting Jingle Bells, and I'm going to play.
You went really slow on Jingle Bells. Yeah? It's okay. We can do this. You too, Buzz. Here we go.
Thank you.
All right, we have one more tune for you. This is music from the Nutcracker. Don't they sound better than like 5 weeks ago? Yeah, awesome. All right, we're gonna do one more song for you and then senior jazz. You guys are ready to roll? Okay.
Okay, team. And remember, quarter notes short, like the don't, and it'll stay together. Okay, here we go. If you grit your teeth, it looks like you're smiling. Perfect. Okay, here we go. To get in place.
Go one over. Jared, over the, is that someone's seat?
No.
Why doesn't he have a Hello. Ooh, that worked, didn't it? All right, our senior jazz is about to perform for you. They're going to do three numbers. There's something. What's the first song on the program? What does it say? Herald Angels Swing is our first tune. This one has, I think, some solos. Who are the solos? There's a clarinet solo, I think that's Marcus. Who's the other solo? Ooh, and a violin solo. So our jazz bands aren't necessarily the typical jazz bands. Because we're like, come join us, that's cool. It doesn't matter if you play a trombone or saxophone or trumpet or piano or drums or something, you can just play whatever. So we have violin and we have clarinet and we have a whole section of flute somewhere in there. So we love having the big group, but we can almost do concert band music, just saying. Herald Angels Swing, here we go. That didn't have a violin solo. But that was Marcus on clarinet. Way to go, Marcus. Yes. Okay, so Mr. Kirkpatrick's going to attempt to be the moving microphone for this next bunch. We have Let It Snow times three. Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. You know, that one? This one has a couple solos. We've got Eric on tenor sax, Kevin on violin. Did I miss anyone? Going once, going twice. Nope, that's the next one. Okay, so Let It Snow. Eric, And now, one more non-seasonal tune. This song I introduced to the band a while ago. And I've been looking for this piece of music forever because it's such a cool arrangement. I'm just going to like prop it all up and hopefully it sounds great. But this tune, if you ever look up this song on YouTube, you'll find some really interesting performances of this tune in like New Orleans. And usually they're marching down a street. And it's called Just a Closer Walk. If you haven't heard it before, look it up. But it starts out slow and slow. And then goes into a fast swing. You should look up the videos though. It's really interesting to watch. There's one with Wynton Marsalis leading the way. It's very cool. So we can't march around the gym, I'm sorry. But maybe next time, eh?
Should we memorize it next time?
All right, this one features a few solos. We've got Ethan on trombone over here. We have Kevin on violin again, I think. We have Jake on alto, and we have Alex on tuba. A really shiny tuba tonight. Yes, I know, right? So, a traveling mic. Okay, so here's what you gotta do, you guys. Mr. Kirkpatrick's gonna need to know who's next. He's first. We're gonna make this work. Just cue him so he knows who's next, okay?
Stand up super early, okay?
Here we go.
Okay, woo. So our next group. Shh. Is our grade 9 junior band. This group has been amazing this semester. Amazing in lots of ways. But also really great musicians. We are gonna play two songs for you, mostly because the second one's gonna just like waste their face, so we can't do anything after that, they need a break. The first one is called Luna y Fuego. Did I get it? Who's the composer? I don't know, it's in the program. This is Luna y Fuego, and it's kind of a Spanish march. The trumpets will not take over the band, I promise.
Right, trumpets? Yes.
They didn't even hear me. Here we go.
Trumpets, behave, Ethan. Behave. I know how this works. Somebody's phone's ringing. It's a nice ringtone.
Ding dong.
Hopefully it stops eventually. It's not as loud as the train, so, you know. Can you guys, you got a note at the beginning of the song, everybody, right? Can you just play your first note and hold it, just the first note. Ready? And go. So remember, 20% more than 10% less, including you guys. You're not allowed to power it out. You guys. Okay. Is it distracting anybody else? Okay, good. Thank you.
Santa Rocks the House. And the bass instruments often get kind of boring parts in songs. So they're like, can we get a song that has more notes? I'm like, okay. So this one, they actually get no spot to breathe. Like, it's just go. They always are like holding their faces by the end of it. So Santa Rocks the House has a super awesome bass line. And it's all just pretty excited and loud. You ready? Okay, that's as much as I can stall for them. Here we go.
Phone's ringing again. Hopefully it's in the right key. All right, here we go. You hear it now? One, two, one, two, three, and.
Thank you. Okay, as these guys are transitioning to the choir, I believe, I just wanted to bring your attention to that table over there. You guys, we have about 30 dozen of Krispy Kreme donuts that need to be sold. And the proceeds of the sales go directly to the music program and to the children that you're seeing tonight. So if you haven't bought any, go buy some. Bring them to work tomorrow. You'll be everybody's favorite employee or boss or friend. So just encouraging you to go over and buy. You can buy them by the dozen, or you can buy one for $2. And we also have coffee, caffeinated and decaf. So go over there and help yourself. In between right now would be the perfect time to go, or any time in the evening. So thank you guys so much.
I guess they can't hear behind the speaker. Okay, so you know how we can't come to school if we're sick? Yeah, there's a few people not here tonight, unfortunately, but this accounts for why this person in the middle here is not really in high school. But she came on our retreat with us several weeks ago, and I texted her an hour before the concert and said, "So, do you want to sing alto with us?"
And so this is Wendy. Yay, Wendy. Woo-woo! She's also one of our music parent committee and plays a mean cowbell, just saying.
Can you guys not talk back there at all? Like, quiet? Thanks.
So this is our choir. We are going to perform for you Carol of the Bells first, and then we're going to do a little special something-something after that.
Something-something.
Something.
Okay. Remember, from above, not below. Okay. Try it again. It's okay. Is it not working? Okay, try it now. Does it work? Test it. Huh, see? Fancy. Okay.
Special something something. So this piece of music has an ensemble to go with it, and we thought, that'd be fun to do. So welcome to Hannah and Zayden and Caitlin and Kevin and Marcus to be part of our ensemble.
Yes, we should clap for them. Thank you.
We're just gonna let them tune up a bit here.
If you need more.
Okay. This piece is called Donat Nobis Pacem. It's written in Latin, and it's written for a small ensemble. We kind of adapted our ensemble a little bit. Caitlin's cello has a broken string, so we got a bassoon. That works. And then another violin part is played by Marcus on clarinet instead of violin. But then the rest of it's all normal, right?
You guys are the normal ones.
Yeah. So big thank you to Hannah, who plays piano over here, for like basically taking the lead and beating these guys into shape. I'm not gonna say she definitely did that, but you know, they're all smiling. We hope you enjoy this one, Donat Nobis Pacem, which means grant us peace, in case you wanna know.
Thank you, Miss Bell.
Thank you so much. We're just going to switch now over to our senior concert band. You guys get in place, and Quinn's going to say something to you. If you could listen up. Shh, shh, shh.
All right, all right. I know I'm not the type of guy that you see every now and then. And I'm not the type of guy that always comes down and gives a speech to everybody in the class. But I've got a couple of special announcements. So, today, my mom had puppies. They were due. There's five of them. Three boys and two girls. I thought she wasn't going to make it here today. But that's her in the crowd over there with the black phone. I am so honored for her to be here. I'm so honored for her to be here. Like, I didn't think she was going to show up. Not seeing her loved one perform in front of her, that'll be a big disappointment, to say the least. Also, I wanted to give another shout-out to Mr. Nasser. This dude is a music legend. This is the same guy who played Coconut Mall. Freaking Coconut Mall! You 2010s kids know what I'm talking about. Anyway... And another thing, I am so honored to be such a part of an amazing community. Back then, I never thought I would do what I'm able to do. Cheer up people, make them laugh, make their day, you know? Oh, I am so glad there are so many lovely and amazing people I met along the way that make me the way I am today. And another one that I want to point out, Mr. Liversidge the GOAT. He's over there! Give him a round of applause. For building such an amazing school, and I met his grandson, Brayden. He's a redhead like me, and I love that kid dearly. I hope whatever he's doing nowadays, he makes the best of his life. Yep, he's happy. So, I'd like to honor the next performance from a band. Happy holidays and Merry Christmas, everybody!
Okay, now I don't have to do as many thank yous, so that's good. Thanks, Quinn. Appreciate it. I wouldn't have done as good a job anyway. Okay, our next group is our senior concert band. What time is it? Oh, we're rocking. Okay, so our senior concert band is going to perform three songs for you. The first one is not conducted by me. Ha! So, Ashton, come on down. This is Ashton. He's in grade 11. I would clap, but I have hands full. And he's going to introduce the first song as well.
I'll go be you.
Yeah. Okay. So, the first song we are playing tonight for senior concert band, we're playing Epic Gaming Themes. This piece is arranged by Paul Murtha, and it has a lot of exciting changes throughout the song. The first part of the song is very mysterious, and then it moves to a more calm section, and then intense. It's really quite the piece, and I can't wait to present it to you all.
Thank you.
Thank you.
my music. I know, but unless it's a real train going through the middle of the gym, I don't want the noise.
Yes, during Polar Express, we have to have it, right?
They want the train on. I told them they'll have to wait till Polar Express. Next time I want a real train, by the way. You see these trains? I need it like, what is that, like 100 times bigger? Something like that, you know? I want a real train. It'd be fun. I know, but it'd be fun. Okay, we're going to do another song. I am going to conduct this one. This is a piece based on Irish folk music. The composer lived in Ireland for a while and got really inspired by the music there. This is called Wicklow. And, well, that's all I'm going to tell you about it. Next. Right? I am stalling for a sec. This group meets every second day, which is fantastic because it means they get class all year, except we're not used to every second day anymore, so it feels unfantastic sometimes. I want them every day, all year. That'd be even better. But the other groups you've seen so far, the grade 8s and the grade 9s, have class just this semester. And hopefully they'll want to like carry on and do some stuff next semester, so maybe they'll figure out a way to make that happen. Last year's grade 8s and 9s did, right? They're not with me. It's okay. They did. They were amazing. Did I stall long enough? So this is our senior band doing Wicklow.
Hey bagpipes, how you doing? Ready for this? Yeah, you are. Be all sweet and beautiful and lovely, except the bagpipes. You guys get to be drones.
Thank you.
All right, we have one more song before we have a big, huge, mass band Polar Express with all our grade 9, 10s, 11, and 12s. Whew, I can't talk. So, I'm not there again. The next song is going to be conducted by, do you want to talk to them?
Sure.
By this guy. He promised not to tell a depressing story, so the last time I let him have the mic, he was like, this is the song we're playing and I hate it. And I was like, that was a nice intro. So this is Ethan, and he's going to conduct the next song.
So we're going to be playing Nightmare Before Christmas. It's was made by Danny Elfman, but it's arranged by Michael Brown. And it's basically my favorite childhood movie. So here we go.
Thank you.
Okay. I didn't bet Mr. Kirkpatrick again. I should have. So last year, 5 weeks ago, I won the bet, by the way. We were out of the gym by 9:30, in case you were there last time. We didn't wager anything, though. It's kind of disappointing. But I was correct, so that was handy. However, we didn't bet anything this time, but I was thinking a good wager would have been, can we be done the concert by 9? And we're going to be done the concert by 9. I'm going to turn the mic over to Mr. Liversidge for a sec and let him do a little bit of closing, and then I'll spiel a little bit more.
I just wanted to take acknowledgement to the outstanding leadership that your children get through Ms. Bell and Mr. Kirkpatrick. So a round of applause for them, please. High school should be about taking the opportunity to say yes to some really cool things. This is a really cool thing. To have a concert that goes from Krispy Kreme donuts, not hot cross buns, through Mozart to finishing with 100 kids playing the same song together, that's pretty cool. Quinn alluded to my nephew. He said grandson. I kind of am offended. He also mentioned that he was, quote, a ginger too. Sorry, Quinn, I used to be a ginger and this is what happens. Braden came through Garibaldi Music, and Braden is now one of five French horn players in the UBC Woodwinds and UBC Concert Band. So progressing through high school band up to probably the highest level we have in British Columbia at university level band. And the opportunities are here, and they're presented and cared for and tenured by these two adults. So we're very thankful for that. So. Without further ado, back to the fabulous and talented Ms. Bell.
All right. So I always think after the concert, oh, I should have done that and I should have said that. Okay, so we're going to attempt to not have regrets. We already had Quinn talk about our amazing sound guy. We also have Victor over here who graduated 10 years ago. There you go, that was nice. Who's doing the live stream for us tonight. So thank you, Victor, because Tim Adams, who has been doing it, who graduated also 3 years ago, because really doesn't have a kid in the program anymore, but he has to go to France. So that's where he is. So Tim, if you're watching, we miss you terribly, but we don't feel sorry for you because you went to France, right? We have not done the Polar Express for 3 years. This was a tradition. We'd always have a mass band at the end of the concert, the Polar Express. So I'm so happy that we actually get to do this again. And I don't know, it looks like more people, I don't know. But there's a lot of shiny up here on stage, hey? Yeah. They practiced this piece together once, last week. So they got to do it once, so that's cool. They're gonna be amazing. Totally together, perfect. I also have to say a quick thank you to our music parent committee who's over there and the volunteers who are over there selling things and helping you at the door and getting you seats. Singing with our choir, you know, all the things that they do. There's so many things they do to help out. We'd love to have especially more like younger students, parents on our music parent committee, because it's great to get new ideas and new people in. If you have anything that you might want to contribute to that, you just talk to them over there and they'll snag you. What have I missed? Going once.
Buy donuts.
Buy donuts. Oh yeah, you guys, I don't want to sell those tomorrow. Please buy some donuts. How much do we have left?
Donuts.
There's only 8 dozen left. You know, 3 years ago, when this happened at the end of the concert, someone went and bought all 8 dozen and then just donated them. I'm just saying, it's an idea.
Just an idea. I don't know who it was, but it was a great idea because I didn't have to sell anything the next day. I know, right? So, the Polar Express. Oh, I did forget something. So I invited some students that graduated 10,000 years ago to come back if they wanted to and play Polar Express. And some of them showed up. Fun. Some of them have lives and couldn't get here, but some showed up. Who are you? Stand up if you're one of those people. Stand up. Stand up taller. Okay, cool. Yes, there we are. All right. So welcome back to them for the Polar Express. They didn't get to do this last year, so. There are some in the audience, too. Where are they? Diego, are you back there? I have a baritone right here. Right here, man. Ah, they wimped out on me. Okay, well, you guys get to cheer really loud then. Daniel, I see you too. Okay, cheer really loudly for us. This is the Polar Express.
Right? Okay. Team? Dynamics matter. It means that we can actually hear parts we need to hear. If you can't see me from where you are, get somewhere where you can see me, because it's super important that you actually know what is going on here, okay? If you're behind me because you're curved that way, good luck. Okay. If I do this, it's not a high five. Just saying. If I do this, I probably won't do that to you guys. Okay. Where's my cymbal, people? Fantastic. I'll give you 1, 2, and then you're in, okay?
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Just a reminder that the students are going to stay really quick and clean up. It is 8:55:09. We should be done in like 10, 15 minutes, if everybody helps. Chairs. These non-foldable ones go back to the cafeteria. Folding ones go onto chair racks at the back. If you want to help and make things faster, go, go, go. Thank you. Have a good night.